Are you enjoying the red era so far? So, you know, the Red Album is actually an album I have gotten to record and release twice now. And the reason for that being is that ever since I was a teenager, it's been really, really important for me personally to one day own my own music, my own art, my own work. And so that was something I always wanted to do. A couple years ago, I announced that I planned on re-recording and re-releasing all of my first six albums and calling them Taylor's version, which means that it's mine. Is a by definition, that is a passion project, which is something that an artist will do just because it's personal for them, not because they expect it to do well commercially. And so I went into the project not expecting that you guys would jump on board with it or support my versions of this music. Which, let me tell you, when the first one that I put out, Fearless, my version, came out, you guys were like, no, we're supporting these ones. We care about what you care about. If you want to own your work, we're 100% behind you on that. So thank you for that, guys. I'll never stop thanking you for that, because it's just such generous. It's such generosity of spirit, honestly, to do that for me. And we actually do have another re-record Taylor's version coming out pretty soon, which is exciting. I've got Speak Now, my version, is coming out July 7th. I'm so excited about it. But one thing that's really fun about going back and re-recording these albums is I'm able to go back to the project as a whole. And I'm able to go back to the source material and what the album originally was going to be, whether that's songs that didn't end up making the album or songs that were originally much longer than they ended up being. So there is one more song from Red that I'd like to play if you happen to have 10 minutes to spare.
Turning red, I used to be a little kid with glasses and a twin. Thank you. there, I was there. Sacred prayer, I was there, I was there.